Last year, the shift to a federal form of government was nothing more than a proposal from a presidential candidate who wasn't even leading the surveys yet.
We have to go federal. And I would have, marami kasing klase in federal. You can copy the pure federal system sa England or federal system France where you elect the president. Siya lang, nation. Or the Malaysian experience. Sectoral and everybody is represented.
Today, the proposal is fast becoming a reality. And with what appears to be congressional backing, it may not be long before the Philippines moves from being a unitary presidential form of government to a federal parliamentary form with a president and a prime minister.
Independent states who will be free to have their own economic policies. They can manage their own natural resources, and they can chart their own destinies.
While many in the business community agree that federalism looks good on paper, they warn the devil is always in the details. Cesar Vidata, who became prime minister during the Marcos year, says the toughest part of the job will be allocating resources.
Because we have a number of regions that cannot be self-supporting.
Government plans to divide the country into 11 to 12 states, lumping some rich and poor regions together. As for Vidata, he suggests starting simple.
We have only three states, the states of Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao.
Why would that be better? Why would that be?
Because there are more provinces and cities that can help each other within the established region in the Philippines. And we have three stars in the flag.
Tax was also high on the agenda, with federalism expected to give states a free hand in setting up rates as a way to stay competitive.
Based on the region, we'll have to craft their own laws, craft their own taxation system, craft their own revenue raising, and then entice foreign investment to come to the respective region. Everybody now will be involved in nation building.
But for Peter Wallace, there are some tax matters best left to the national government.
Some taxes which are national in scope, like corporate income tax and personal salary tax and so on. But the states have flexibility to provide incentives against that.
Urban planner architect June Palafox is excited to see the country transition to federalism, saying if other countries can do it, so can the Philippines.
The Philippines is 400 times the size of Singapore. It's 350 times the size of Hong Kong, and 8 times the size of Taiwan, and 3 times the size of South Korea. So Luzon, Visayas, Mindanao, just like one Korea each.
The government is looking at setting up a federal form of government in 6 years, considered a short time if you think about all the capacity-building programs needed to empower provinces and cities that will make up the states. Several businessmen, however, point out, looking at the president's track record in Davao, he might just be able to get the job done. Michelle Long, ABS-CBN News.